Property Star here. What is going on? We're playing some Tribes Ascend, and I know it's been quite a while since I made a Tribes Ascend video, and I apologize for that, and I'm pretty sad about that as well, because it's not just that I haven't been making videos, it's also that my game hasn't been working. I haven't actually been able to play Tribes, and in the meantime, there's been about three, maybe four patches that I've completely missed, not had a chance to talk to you guys about. There's tons of new maps, tons of new weapons. I'm using two of them right now. There was a patch a while ago that added 27, I believe, weapon variants to the game. The Brute got a big update, so now he has plasma rifles and stuff, and that's what we're playing right now. We're going to be showing some clips of me playing the Brute with this loadout that I've really come to love right here. In particular, the weapon that I love is this heavy Spinfusor that I'm using right now, and you know it's better because it's red. If you make any weapon red, naturally it's going to be more powerful, as well as the shotgun being red, but I'm kind of leaving shotguns behind. Shotguns in this game got to a certain point for me where sometimes there's guns that are just so good I don't want to use them because they're that good, and that is shotguns and Tribes. They get pretty ridiculous. But back to the heavy Spinfusor, which I am really in love with right now. Basically what this red gun does is real Soviet damage, because when you direct hit somebody with this gun, they are pretty much dead. It does insane amounts of damage. I'm pretty sure it kills medium classes in one hit. The downside, however, is that the explosion radius on it is smaller, which not a big deal if you're just going to be direct hitting people. It also does a ton of damage on turrets, generators, and especially shrikes. Check out the ridiculous amount of damage on this thing.
Chessbot!
And that is why I love this gun. This is what Tribes is all about. Direct hitting things with a projectile weapon while they're in midair. And I know I feel bad about spamming this guy out with a shotgun right now, so I take out my Spinfusor, midair him, and I felt bad. So hopefully I made up for that. Hopefully we're cool now that I midaired you. We're all good. Everything's fine now. Another big change to Tribes Ascend that happened, which might have been overlooked, is the fact that when you are reloading a weapon that you aren't currently holding, so let's say I shoot my Spinfusor and take out my shotgun, my Spinfusor will be reloading while I'm not holding it, kind of like a flare gun in Team Fortress 2, and they decrease the time for that down to 3 seconds. Before, I think it used to be 5, and that is awesome. That is a huge thing for me, because now it means that I don't need to rely on having a shotgun nearly as much, where before you kind of do need a secondary to wait until your primary is ready to shoot again or something like that. Now you don't have to wait nearly as long, which I am in love with, because all I want to do is use the Spinfusor, so reload faster for me, please, thank you. Throw more fractals, walk into it, thanks, I deserve this double kill. Speaking of fractals, I don't want to use you either. I hate fractal grenades. There are some items in this game, like fractals, I just wish they would just remove. They were cool for about a day when they were first released, but now it's just, I don't want to deal with this anymore. Get rid of this stupid brain dead item and put like a giant sock in its place. I'd rather throw socks at people, okay? Really, without this going into a big giant rant or anything like that, or a huge discussion on things I don't like about Tribes, it really does boil down to the one thing I don't like about Tribes Ascend is a lot of the most annoying weapons that you really don't want to fight against just seem to be the ones that get used the most often. Like fractals. Please leave me alone. Anyway, this is going down a dark, dark path. Let's talk about something awesome really quickly. The lightweight perk, which was added to the game for the acceleration patch, does exactly that. It accelerates you to ridiculous speeds very fast. You can get to about 230 from using one impact nitron. It is a ton of fun to use. The big downside to it is that your health does not regenerate for about ever, five ever. It never really happens. But to be able to go that quick, that quickly, you know what I mean? It's a ton of fun, and it really opens up a lot of options for chasing flag carriers now that kind of weren't there before. And another big one, Stonehenge, the map. I'm really liking this map. It's one of the better additions to the game. It's currently kind of in a beta phase, and that is all I've got for you guys right now. I know it's not pronounced Stonehenge, but I'm sort of hoping we can make that happen. It sounds a lot better. So, peace out, everybody. Hope you enjoyed this, and I'll catch you next time. See you later.
Oh, you dropped it? I'm gonna return it! Oh, he is. Now get it again, sir. Oh, oh shit.
Destroyed.
Our flag is secure.
Wait,